as Prime prepares itself a path to victory in a few days' time, we welcome you tonight to ACL Prime 63 tonight, the Gold Club Show for the 2018 edition of Path to Victory tonight. Tonight we have quite the stacked on, heading into quite possibly one of the biggest events leading up to the Grand Slam from Prime's side of things tonight. And with so much tension, so much in the air tonight, it's only a matter of time before we find out the final card. I'm Bradley James, your ACL commentator, as always, ladies and gentlemen, tonight. And Caesar's going to be a starting off of singles action, as two teams who will be participating in the Path to Victory match are going to get set for a Path to Victory advancement match, as one member of the Q-Rangers will be facing off against one member of the Azure Knights of Hacker Club tonight in the opening contest for Prime. But imagine what this will do for the winning side tonight. Whoever wins this match will get climb up in the rankings to select their spot for the Path to Victory match. And you know Stinger has to be feeling good if he's going to be representative for the Q-Rangers tonight. But you have to imagine that even one of these two men, Pidge or Orca, would be a dangerous man to face off against. The unhinged nature of Azure Kite, but the absolute brawling style of Azure Orca, on the other hand, is definitely something that you would need to look out for going into this match. And that is a damn good chance that it could be dangerous for either member. Stinger could be in for quite the match tonight, depending on who ends up being the member of Hacker Club that ends up being represented here tonight. Because either of the Azure Knights could be a dangerous man to face off against. And we're about to find out which member of the Azure Knights will be facing off against tonight. Stinger on one corner, and Azure Orca on the other. And this match is underway, ladies and gentlemen. And ladies and gentlemen, Orca already delivering quite the powerhouse achievement in this match already from the word go. And again, ladies and gentlemen, this advancement match will decide the rankings. We'll decide who climbs up in the rankings for the Path to Victory match for the number selection on the night, ladies and gentlemen. And Orca already dominating in tough force tonight in the early goings of this contest. You know, you have to imagine for a damn fact that Orca is just going to come in, dominate, and absolutely decimate Stinger in this contest. An Irish whip by Orca, setting Stinger to reverse. Stinger with the reversal. Both teams who recently banded together just this season alone. Both members who have basically been wanting to get the taste for tag team gold early on this season. But their path to victory could easily lead to a win for their respective teams. I mean, imagine if even one of these four men were to basically win the Path to Victory match, they would gain quite the lead for their respective units, and that is no understatement, ladies and gentlemen. That is a damn fact. And that is the reality of the situation that could happen when Path to Victory rolls around next week. I mean, Path to Victory, it's one of the big free events that ACL has brought to the board ever since we came onto the scene. With Rebound, Path to Victory, and the All-Star Grand Slam being the big free of our year, of our season, of our yearly season calendar, you have to imagine that either one of these teams is going to head into the biggest, into the second of the big three and looking to dominate the match that will either get, that will give them a world title match of their, will give them a world title match for their respective brand. So even one of these men could even face off against Orochi or Barrett Wallace, depending on who ends up walking out of Path to Victory, the world champion. And my God, Stinger! with that running power slam into the corner right, sending Walker right into the corner there. That feat of strength right there by the Poison Star, ladies and gentlemen. And it looks as, and again, going back to this match, the Orange Poison Star, the Cure Rangers, definitely was trying to make some type of headway going into this contest against the absolute powerhouse of Hacker Club in Astro Orca, but my god, I think it might be too much for him to handle. He's being placed up in a bad way here tonight. And it does not look like he's going to be in a good way going into this match. One, two, no, only a one count. Amazing. Stinger still alive in this contest after everything that's been flung at him thus far. But wait a minute. And oh my god, the Azure End being placed onto Sorcery Orange there. One, two, no! What the hell, Lucky? Lucky, what the hell were you doing there? I mean, they're saving your partner and then there's blatantly being a nuisance to the referee. He was just trying to do his job, Lucky. What the hell were you doing there? My god, I mean, Jesus Christ, ladies and gentlemen, what the hell did we just see there? What the hell did we just see there with Lucky? I mean, it looked like he was trying to save. It looked like he was, in fact, trying to save. It did look like he was trying to save Stinger there because he knew he was down for the count. But what the hell, Lucky? But going back to this match, Orca picking up exactly where he left off there, ladies and gentlemen. Going right into the corner and sending it. But wait a minute, no. Stinger trying to fight back as much as he possibly can. Remember, whoever wins this match will gain an upper echelon in the path to victory standings for their number placement. So you know there's a lot on the line for both teams, for both sides of the coin here, ladies and gentlemen. And here we go. Stinger might be looking to, no, wait, no. Orca on the other hand, but no, the back and forth between both of these men, it's just too much. Both of these men just going at each other wildly in this match. Stinger up the top, and no, the 450 does not connect. Instead, Orca picking him up and putting him in place. With that Samoan drop, I think he might be ready to put Stinger down for the count once and for all there. He's gonna go for that Azure Edge, the free knees and the back drop right there. And now Lucky, wait a minute. One, two, three. And a much needed win tonight for the members of the Azure Knights. And Azure Orca specifically putting in one hell of a match tonight. And as a result, Azure Orca goes up the rankings in the path to victory standings and will have a better chance going into the match as opposed to both members of the Q Rangers. And you have to imagine that he is feeling damn good about this win tonight, as he walks in to represent Hacker Club in that match with a better standing. Congrats, Azure Orca, for this win tonight. And that will be the opening contest. Back on Prime, ladies and gentlemen, as we get set for the next contest of the night, as your crossover champion Sho Minamimoto looks to enter tonight going into Path of Victory, where he will defend the Crossroads Championship against the Avenger of Hinamizawa. Against the Avenger of Hinamizawa, Ikeichi Miyabara. And he's looking to walk into that event next week with a win tonight, as he faces off against one half of the legendary defenders in Pidge, who is definitely looking for some revenge against Sho for the embarrassing match for his partner Thieves, who just under a month ago faced off for the Crossroads Championship after beating him just a few weeks prior to that match. And now Pidge is looking for revenge here tonight in what will be what could be Sho's last match as Crossroads Champion, should he walk out of Path of Victory without the belt. But again, this is all what-ifs at this point. This is realistically just all what-ifs at this point. I mean, given the repertoire that Sho has been going with ever since he won the belt back at Full Metal Panic, dethroning then-champion Ron Masao Tome for the belt, you just have to imagine that this man is going to do whatever it takes to walk out with the win tonight. I mean, this man has just been dominant. The Reaper of Shibuya has been dominant ever since he came into ACL. He's looking to make tonight no different, as he's looking to make a message clear to Keiichi, and he's looking to beat down Pidge as a result. But speaking of the Green Lion, here he comes. The Green Lion of the legendary defenders of Voltron. Here he is tonight. And again, like I stated before, he is looking to come into this contest with one hell of a win tonight. Not just leading into Path to Victory, but also for his brother in arms, for the legendary defenders and a former tag team champion in his own right, in Keith. Tonight, it could all come down to this. This could realistically be a huge win for Pidge tonight, should he walk away with the win. I mean, this could be a big win for Pidge going into Path to Victory, because he will be one of the members, a part of the Path to Victory match, while Sho will be defending the Crossroads Championship at that event as well. So both men have a lot to prove going into next week, going into that event in a few days' time. But you have to imagine that even with all of that, you have to imagine that this could be quite the huge momentum that could be needed from both men. But again, Sho obviously dominating the early goings of this match, and he's just looking to go right after the Green Lion and embarrass him in the same manner that he embarrassed Keith. And wait a minute, not even letting him get up. One roll up, and no, Pidge reverses it. Not even getting a one that time. Of course, Sho just going right after Pidge, and no, Pidge trying his best to land as much blows as he possibly can. But given everything that has happened thus far in this match, given everything that the legendary defenders have done, given everything that Sho Minamimoto has done, given everything that both men have done this season, it would be criminal to think that either of these men could have the advantage, given everything they've already done this season alone. This season alone, ladies and gentlemen. But yet, Pidge still coming in with that fighting spirit tonight. And wait a minute, springboard splash right onto Sho. And you know, say what you will about Pidge, some people claim that he's the so-called weak link of the legendary defenders, but he's putting in work tonight against Sho Minamimoto, and he's putting in work to prove that he's not a weak link, and he can. Oh my god, Connor from right out of nowhere, right there by Pidge, and that's what I've been talking about. But of course, Sho with that reversal with that knee right to the face of Pidge right there. And just pummeling those left hooks right to the face of Pidge right there. Jesus Christ, ladies and gentlemen. But of course, Pidge not looking to go down without a fight. Neck breaker right there from out of nowhere. And now dragging Sho. And now, wait a minute. Oh, God, a baseball slide elbow right there onto Sho Minamimoto. I mean, goddamn, everything that we've seen thus far with these two, it's insane. It is absolutely nuts, ladies and gentlemen. Yet the flip over right there by Pidge. And now, back suplex connecting right there by Pidge. Looking for that pin now. One. Only a one count. Damn it all. Only a one count. Of course, Pidge not looking to give up so quickly. Not looking to give up so quickly tonight against Sho. No, wait, no, kick. Kick to the side and now. What the heck has Pidge got in store here now? Irish whip. Right to the corner. Has Pidge got something in store for Sho? And wait a minute. Oh, wait, what the hell? Move of desperation time on the part of Pidge here tonight. Looking to go for the pin. Looking to go for a superplex to the outside. Superplex to the outside. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. Move of desperation on the part of Pidge there, ladies and gentlemen. Knowing damn well that he could have easily put the hand off fucking Sho Minamimoto there, but Sho ain't going down like that, throwing him onto the barricade and throwing him right back in. Sho still managing to get up even after that. That's absolutely insane that a knee to the face of, wait a minute, clothesline. Flying clothesline right there, and again working with those right, looking at those left hooks again. That demented, blackened up left hook right there, Sho Minamimoto. As he focuses his efforts, and Pidge is just lying on the outside after everything he's given for this match already. It's just absolutely insane! Insane! That after what Pidge did to him earlier, Sho is not even showing even a bit. My God! That there, ladies and gentlemen, that there right there is just the resiliency and the absolute tenacity of the current world of the current crossover champion. Wait a minute. He could be going for the Zeta slow kick right there. Zeta slow kick connects. Zeta slow kick connecting right there onto Pidge. And I think Pidge might be in trouble here. Could be down. One, two, no! Pidge is still alive. Pidge is still alive in this match. But for how long? For how long will Pidge be able to stay alive in this contest given everything that has been done so far to him? Even after everything that has been done, after everything that he has done in this contest, still trying to come back with that combination. And wait a minute. And the sidekick right to the head of Sho. And Sho once again could be in trouble, but no! Right hook right there by Sho. And a clothesline for good measure. And now Sho looking to pick up Pidge. And now a combination strike of his own. Combination connecting, and now going off the ropes, and a flying clothesline connecting, sending him right to the corner now. And now Pidge looking to push the exclamation mark, but no! Shotgun dropkick not connecting, and wait a minute, no, this could be it for Pidge! Number Cruncher! Number Cruncher, that lung blower powerbomb could be it! That could be it for Pidge! That could be it for Pidge, damn it all! One, two, three! And Sho Minamimoto will walk into next week to that crossover championship defense with one hell of an advantage. We'll walk into huge momentum into that match next week. Pidge all his credit. He gave one hell of a match tonight. He gave one hell of a match tonight. You cannot take that away from Pidge. He did all he possibly could tonight. But unfortunately, it wasn't enough. It wasn't enough to keep Sho down. And he will walk into path of victory to his defense of the Crossover Championship with the momentum. Wait! Never mind! Keiichi Miyabara not allowing this to be how it goes down leading into path to victory next week. He's looking to put... No! Sho with the reversal! Sho with the reversal! Now Keiichi with the reversal! These two men who will go to war for the Crossover Championship next week in a few days time at Path to Victory. These two men will do battle for the Crossover Championship. And you know for a damn fact that these two men are going to go to absolute war with each other for that belt. Backside suplex right there by Sho. And it looks as though the Reaper of Shibuya is looking to make a clear-cut statement to the Avenger of Hinamizawa. But of course, Keiichi. Oh, God, no! No Sho with the reversal there. And Sho looking to put him over to the ropes now. What on earth has Sho got in mind? Oh, God, no. Sho's got something dangerous in store. Wait a minute! Wait! Oh, my God! Shoulder block to the outside! Diving shoulder block to the outside right there by Sho Minamimoto! And Keiichi lying flat down there. And Sho beating down on his challenger for the belt next week. Ladies and gentlemen,
nobody moves, nobody gets hurt.
And ladies and gentlemen, the Outlaws have specifically asked for this time, ladies and gentlemen. They weren't scheduled to be out here tonight, but considering the fact that your current tag team champions, after a message that they got last week, specifically asked for this time out here tonight to specifically call out the member of the locker room that decided to play what they call a little prank on them last week, and decided to call out to them using a specific little card in their locker room that was left last week, as we all saw last week, ladies and gentlemen. And tonight, it looks as though that the current tag team champions are looking to call out whoever decided to give that calling card, as it were, labeled under a specific group that is notorious for them. And they're looking to find out who specifically gave them that card and left it in their locker room last week.
You can't be serious! They're really going to be... Is this really going to happen apart from the victory?
If you haven't subscribed to the Video Game Wrestling Network yet, here's what you've been missing. Video Game Wrestling Network, the only network for you. The most awesome experience network in CAW today.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back after that commercial break as we get set to announce the final card that has now been officially finalized and put to print here tonight. For the Path to Victory event next week, as we can officially announce it here tonight before the main event. One of the big three will be happening next week, and the Anarchy Sisters in their first defenses of the belt will defend against Yang Shaolong and Blake Belladonna of Team Ruby. Will the former Lioness Tag Team Champions be able to regain their gold, or will the Anarchy Sisters bring in a new era indeed? And then, Jota Okuja and Kaji Tatsumi will take on Sans of the Pirates of the Bone Bros. As Juvenile Delinquency beats the Bone Bros. Will two standout tag teams of Millennium go to war? Who will come out of it with the gold? We'll find out next week. And then, Chris and the Seared Flame defends the Sky High Championship against Dave Strider. The dominant Seared Flame Champion will defend against the upstart anti-cruiserweight, but who will walk out with the belt? And then, as we just saw, the Outlaws will defend the tag team titles against the Phantom Fiends. After the revelation we just saw before the commercial break, will the Phantom Fiends actually arrive next week, or is it all a ruse, just as Spike Spiegel said? And then, Sasuke Kiryu will face off against Chie Sayanaka, and the Lioness Championship is on the line! Will Sasuke Kiryu be able to defend the championship against Chie, or will the Dragon of Inaba become a Lioness Champion? And then, Sho vs. Keiichi for the Crossover Championship! It's Keiichi's first pay-per-view match in the 2 years! But will he be too rusty to take down the Reaper Shibuya? We will find out next week! And then, the main event for Millennium, Brock Howard versus Nidai for the Millennium Championship. Brock Howard's had a very up and down year thus far, but can he finally pull out the big win over Nakamura Nidai? Or will the Diamond Despair walk out still Millennium Champion? And then, Barrett takes on Orochi for the World Championship for the main event of Prime. But who will walk out in this collision of giants for the World Championship? And then it's 30 men. It's the yearly tradition. 30 men representing for 5 and millennia. But who will walk out with a shot at their brand's respective world title match at Path, at the end of Path to Victory? We will find out next week. But as we get set for the main event of the evening, and it's a tag team match between the Orochi clan and their respective challenges for their go next week, as Barrett Wallace and Dave Strider tag up tonight to face off against Orochi and Chris of the Seared Flames. Barrett Wallace has been dominant over the past few weeks ever since Jax was taken out, and he has been dubbed by both the fans and the members backstage as the hero Prime may well need in this dark time. And he has been quite possibly the only man who has gotten this close to beating Orochi. But will he be able to beat him down after everything that he's been doing the past few weeks? Has it made Orochi too soft to beat? Has it made Orochi stronger? Or is he just pissed him off so much that he's gonna be in for one rough night at Path to Victory? And speaking of men who have got quite a lot under their belts in a few weeks' time, Dave Strider will get his shot at the Sky High Championship in just a few days' time when he faces off against Chris of the Seared Flame. Of course, Chris, who has been dubbing himself the anti-cruiserweight ever since he became a part of the Sky High division, has stated in no uncertain terms that he basically does not care for the more high-flying style. But as of late, he's adopted that type of style into his repertoire. So with that new hybrid style that he is now bringing to the table, will he be able to put down Chris of the Seared Flame next week? I mean, given the fact that the Sky High division has definitely been needing a hero of their own right, will Dave be that unlikely hero for the division come next week? These are the two men who for many months have run dominant all over Prime. The world champion Orochi, the Sky High champion Chris. They represent the Orochi clan. And these two men are most definitely a dangerous force, who have been running dominant alongside Rugal Bergstein at their alongside with them as well. But tonight, you have to imagine that these two have got a lot to deal with tonight, given everything that's gonna happen when these two men walk into this event, walk into next week. You have to imagine that these two, with their dominant tenures as of late, are just feeling absolutely dominant. Hey, wait a minute. Barrett Wallace leading the charge, taking down Orochi to start off this contest tonight. And now just absolute power of strength. And we could be getting a sneak preview of what's going to happen next week. Of what's going to happen at Path to Victory in just a few days' time. And immediately making the tag to Dave. And oh my god, that double team right there by Dave Strider. And Barrett may have made quite the bad decision, but Dave is going to try his best with the advantage that Barrett has given him to try his damn best to make the most of this situation. And immediately tagging Barrett back in. I think he even realized the situation that he was in. And now Barrett looking to take full advantage of that early going odds. And Orochi already, oh god, wait a minute, never mind. Orochi may just be in a spot of trouble, but Dave on the other hand, Dave trying to be as helpful as he possibly can, trying to hold Orochi back while Barrett gets back up. And now getting, and now Dave, thanks to that, has given Barrett a much needed advantage, has given him the advantage once again. And Barrett immediately going for the pin there. One, only a one count. And again, this could realistically be a bit of a preview of what to expect for both members next week. And hey, hey, wait a minute. And again, these two teams are definitely going to be quite, are going to be needing quite the advantage next week. And Dave, once again, getting tagged in on the kick right to Orochi. And for what it's worth, Dave is definitely putting in work tonight, using the agility that he has to his advantage to go after Orochi, but the power and strength of Orochi may just be too much as he's just flung around like that. And now Orochi tagging in Chris, and these two have definitely come to blows before, but now here we go, forearm smash right there by Dave onto Chris. And now looking to go for the tag, but no, Chris not allowing that for 1 second. And these two going back and forth in this contest. Both of these men just going back and forth in this contest thus far. And Dave looking to drag and send him over to the turnbuckle in the corner, make that tag to Barrett and the double team. And I believe the power may be on the advantage of Barrett this time around as he's looking to pummel at the current Sky High champion. The agility of Chris may be a bit too much for him. Remember, while Barrett and Orochi may have power and strength, Dave and Chris cannot be counted out for their skill and agility. But I get the feeling when you're dealing with superhuman strength like both of these other men, that you would realistically just take the loss and just tag back into your partner at this point. I think Chris takes advantage of that and tagging back in Orochi. And now we have it. No. Barrett, after two misfires from both sides, Barrett goes in on it with a deadly clothesline and now setting him up with that. Oh god, the side knee smash right to Orochi. Now going for the pin. One, two, only a two count as Orochi kicks out. Orochi still being as dominant as ever, pummeling. Even if he is being pummeled down by Barrett, the assault by both men and the avalanche splash right onto Orochi. One, two, no! Only a two count! Only a damn two count! And now, throwing hands all over the place. That's why it's not going to be too easy to put Orochi down. But of course, the double team by both members, by the challengers into next week. That is definitely something they would need to look out for. Of course, Orochi not looking to play any games with Dave Strider here tonight. Oh god, a mighty spine buster right there by the dominant world champion. And wait a minute, no, Dave. Dave with the reversal from out of nowhere there. Irish whip right into the corner. And now Dave just trying to throw those hands all over the place. And Dave looking for a move of desperation, working on the knees there of Orochi. And Orochi, and he's just taunting all the way at Chris at the moment. Orochi, Jesus Christ! Finally, Orochi managing to make that, managing as much as he possibly can to make the tag. And he's just making the tag right back to Chris. And Dave just taunting away, and oh god, Chris taking the advantage into the corner with the flurry and barrage of assaults right there. And Chris eyeing down, elbow, no! Does not connect onto Dave. And now Irish whip into the corner. No! Boot right there by Dave. Right onto Dave, I should say. And now Irish whip into the corner. This could be in trouble for Dave, being Irish whipped to the other corner now, and an uppercut right there by the current Sky High champion. And Dave could be in trouble. Wait a minute, no! Reversal right there! And an Irish whip right onto the ropes now. And fleeing that assault right onto Dave. And now calling him back inside. Dave better watch himself, Orochi's eyeing down at him. And Chris still in a pretty dazed state. And Dave, I think he knows exactly what he's going to try to do, but he taunted just a taunt and tease right at Chris now, making the tag once again to Barrett. And I think I know exactly what's going to be happening here. Left arm a slam connecting. And Barrett eyeing down at Orochi, eyeing down at him and saying, this is what's going to happen to you. We're bringing down your reign. And he's taunting down at Orochi and sending the message clear through Chris right here tonight. With that vicious barrage of assault. And wait a minute, no. Wait a minute, no reversal right there. And Barrett with the reversal assault once again. Oh God, and a vicious clothesline. As Chris just rebounds off the rope. Just rebounds off the turnbuckle. And now, picking him up bad. Oh God, breaking the side right there. And I think Barrett is gonna give Chris the advantage that he needs. He's gonna give him, he's signaling to bring it to an end. Here we go, Shipwrecker elbow! 1, 2, 3! And Dave, with the assist from Barrett, and a Shipwrecker elbow right to Chris, makes the win for his team tonight. And both Dave Strider and Barrett Wallace go into next week, go into Pop to Victory, go into their respective matches with one hell of a showing tonight. With a showcase of teamwork, they go into next week with the advantage. And tonight, even if it's just for one night, even if it's just for one instance, a ray of light seems to be shining over Prime, leading into Path to Victory. But will it be enough to take down this era of darkness? We will find out in a few days' time. We will see you at Path to Victory.